Bonjour à tous and welcome to Learn French with Vincent. And we'll see in this video les expressions, but then we'll only focus on one French expression. And the expression that we'll see together is faire mal à quelqu'un. Faire mal à quelqu'un. Faire mal à quelqu'un. Okay, and here is the translation in English. Okay, so faire mal à quelqu'un. And let's see un exemple. Il fait mal à son frère. Okay, so il fait mal. So of course you need to conjugate here the verb faire. And so I've been putting that at the present form. Il fait mal à son frère. His brother. Okay, il fait mal à son frère. But then you can see that in many situations we will replace this à son frère, so as we saw a long time ago, by this pronoun, lui. Okay, so it's a pronoun, un pronom complément d'objet indirect. So basically you get the sentence, il lui fait mal. It's exactly the same, but then you just avoid repeat to repeat this à son frère. So il lui fait mal. So let's see now how we could actually use these pronouns. And then I thought that it might be interesting to put as well these sentences at different tenses. Okay, so the first one, passé composé. And then same thing, I will replace, you know, and I will put the pronoun. So for this one, it's for me, for moi, me, il, me. Normally that's me should be here, but then a fait mal, as usual, will have to go, so you get il m'a fait mal. Il m'a fait mal. Okay, so let's see how it will go for the second person of the singular, so for tu, okay, and in that case it il te faisait mal, so I've been putting this sentence at the imparfait form, il te faisait mal. And now for the masculine singular, so il vient de lui faire mal. And in this sentence, it is at the passé récent form. Il vient de lui faire mal. And then for the feminine singular, you can see that the pronoun is exactly the same. It is lui as well as for the masculine form. Okay, this sentence is at the plus que parfait form, and it will go like il lui avait fait mal. Il lui avait fait mal. Okay, so one more time. Il m'a fait mal, so this is the passé composé. Il te faisait mal, this is l'imparfait. Il vient de lui faire mal, this is passé récent. Il lui avait fait mal, this is plus que parfait. Okay, so this is it for the singular persons, and then now we'll see for the plural. And so, il nous fera mal. Okay, in that case, it's futur simple. Il vous ferait mal. This is conditionnel présent. Il va leur faire mal. This is futur proche, and it's for the third person of the plural, so the masculine one, leur, and then qu'il leur fasse mal, this is subjonctive présent, and then the pronoun here is for the feminine plural, but then basically it's exactly the same as for the masculine plural here, leur and leur, it is the same. Okay, so let's see how it goes. Il nous fera mal, this is le futur simple. Il vous ferait mal, this is conditionnel présent. Il va leur faire mal, this is futur proche. Qu'il leur fasse mal, this is subjonctif présent. I hope it was clear and not too difficult. Don't be afraid to watch it one more time if you want. Have a great day, au revoir et à bientôt.